Top Stories is brought to you by Dawa Khana, Rehari, Chungi, Jammu. SMS services were stopped as a precautionary measure a few hours after postpaid mobile phone connections were restored in Kashmir Valley. Mobile phone services for postpaid subscribers resumed in Kashmir after 72 days on Monday noon, but without any internet facilities. But about 5 p.m., SMS services were stopped too. Home Minister Amit Shah has said that former J&K Chief Minister Umar Abdullah and Mehbooba Mufti have been detained under the Public Safety Act. This remark with a video of the interview was also tweeted by the BJP Live handle. Several mainstream party leaders had been placed under detention ahead of the abrogation of Article 370. Shah added that 4,000 people were taken into preventive custody, but less than 1,000 are still in jail. Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister and National Conference leader Farooq Abdullah's daughter and sister were detained in Srinagar on Tuesday during a protest against abrogation of Article 370 and bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories. Abdullah's sister Suraya and his daughter Safiya were leading the protest against the withdrawal of special status from Jammu and Kashmir. National Institute of Technology Srinagar reopened on Tuesday after being shut for 2.5 months. The institution was closed in a view of security concern in the region post abrogation of Article 370, and the students who belong to states other than Jammu and Kashmir were sent home. Protests by various sections of people over operationalization of a new toll plaza at Saror along Jammu-Pathankot Highway, Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh announced that a discussion was held regarding the same with Minister of Road Transport and Highways Nitin Gadkari. Dr. Jitendra Singh had suggested that imposition of toll tax at Saror should be deferred, keeping in view the peculiar circumstances of transition of the state into Union Territory. Abrogation of Article 370 provisions is a decisive battle waged by the Narendra Modi government to end years of proxy war and terrorism from Pakistan, and the step will bring everlasting peace in Jammu and Kashmir, Union Home Minister Amit Shah said on Tuesday. Chief of Army Staff General Bipin Rawat on Monday said that the armed forces will fight and win the next war with the indigenous weapon systems, and pitched for greater inclusion of homegrown technology in the forces. The general was addressing the 41st DRDO Directors Conference in New Delhi. Addressing the 41st Directors' Conference at Defence Research and Development Organisation, National Security Advisor Ajit Dawal on Tuesday said that India's security vulnerabilities are much greater today, and they are going to be much more greater in the times to come. He said that India has always remained a runner-up in defence technology, and there are no trophies for the runner-ups. Minister Amit Shah on Tuesday said that the Prime Minister Narendra Modi-led government has a policy of zero tolerance towards terrorism, which has termed as the biggest hurdle on the way of development. He also said that India has been a victim of Pakistan-sponsored terrorism since long, while speaking at the National Security Guard 35th Raising Day celebration. Pakistan is on the verge of strong action by the international terror financing watchdog FATF, and the country may be put in the dark grey list. The last warning to improve advertising officials attending the ongoing plenary of the Financial Action Task Force said, as per indications, Pakistan will be isolated by all members for not doing enough. The FATF will finalize its decision on Pakistan on October 18th. Chief Justice of India Justice Ranjan Gogoi on Tuesday said that Wednesday is 40th and last day of hearing in the case of Ram Mandir Babri Masjid land title dispute. The top court had recently said that it would wrap up hearing in the case on October 17th, a day earlier than it was scheduled to. The judgment is likely to be passed on November 4th or 5th. Kashmiri apples with anti-India slogans written on them found in Kathua. Recent consignment of Kashmiri apples received by vendors has anti-national slogans like I love Burhan Wani, Pakistan Zindabad, Meri Jaan Imran Khan, etc. written on them, creating a buzz in Jammu region. corrected history on Tuesday by becoming the first airline in the world to use a taxi bot on an Airbus A320 aircraft operating a commercial flight with passengers on board. A taxi bot is a pilot-controlled semi-robotic tower-less aircraft tractor used as alternate taxiing equipment. Devotees thronged Amritsar's Golden Temple on Tuesday to take a dip in the Holy Sarovar on the occasion of Prakash Gurupurav of Guru Ramdas. Devotees offered prayers to the Sikh Guru in the morning after taking a dip in the holy pool situated inside the premises of the Gurdwara.